even when these public teachers are not propagandizing and indoctrinating your kids. Because there are plenty of good teachers out there. I've had plenty of good teachers in my life. I think even today, there are still some good teachers. But the system broadly is just terrible. There's a story just came out of the Sun about preschool teachers who are giving little kids, we're talking 3-4-year-olds, melatonin patches, drugs on their arms to make them fall asleep. They're calling them sleepy stickers. Two teachers suspended after giving sleepy stickers to preschool children to keep them quiet in class. This is at Northgate Crossing Elementary School in Texas. In Texas, of all places, where a 4-year-old snuck this patch, the so-called sleepy sticker, out of the classroom, showed it to her mom, and then the mom looks at it and says, "Where'd you get this?" The kid says, "My teacher gives it to me for sleeping." They find out the teachers are giving it to all these kids. And the drugs that they're giving them, the original sleep Z patch, has melatonin, L-theanine, GABA, cosmoparine, passion oil, lavender oil, valerian, sensor, aguaganda, and hops. They're not even that cheap. They're $35 for a pack of 28. So the teachers are that desperate to drug the kids and make them fall asleep, they're willing to pay this kind of money. That is Exhibit Z, I don't know. This is evidence number 3,225. Homeschooling or alternatives to the mainstream schools are really important right now because the teachers are allegedly, I have to say allegedly, according to the parents, drugging the kids. Why do I bring all this up? Because there aren't any good public schools? I'm sure there are still good public schools. Because we don't have a political responsibility to take over the schools? We do have a political responsibility to do that. But right now, you have urgent needs to protect your kids and to educate your kids, all right? And when I was a kid, not all that long ago, the thing that we heard, the propaganda was that homeschooling is for hicks and weirdos. That's what we were told. If you send your kid, if you homeschool your kid is not going to be socialized. He's going to be socially awkward. He's going to be a big weirdo. But if you send your kid to the schools, especially the public schools, then your kid will be normal and socialized. Today, that has totally flipped. Because to be normalized into this culture, which is extremely abnormal, means your kid has a 1 in 18 chance of not knowing if he's a boy or a girl. You want your kid to be normalized that way? Normalized into the abnormal, normalized into despair and potentially, God forbid, I don't want my kid to be normalized into that. I meet a lot of homeschool kids. You know, I travel around to a lot of family conferences. I meet students that travel around to different schools. 97% of the time, the homeschool kids I meet, sometimes they're as young as 10 or 11 years old, you know, the younger siblings of whichever kid is coming out to see the speech or something. And then there are many are older, 17, 18. A lot of them are in college now. 97% of the time, the homeschool kids I meet are better educated, more confident, more articulate, more mature than the kids who went to public school or even the fancy private schools. When you have this question of normalizing something, socializing something, those terms don't exist in a vacuum. You're always being normalized into some norm. You're always being socialized into some social group. And today, the dominant social groups are extremely disordered. And it's not just a matter of going through a little rebellious phase and getting a nose ring or something. We're talking about people permanently messing up their biochemistry or leading themselves into anxiety, depression, and the stakes are real. And in one of the less egregious bad outcomes, your 4-year-old is getting drugged by his teacher to go to sleep because no one cares about your kids like you do. Allegedly. That was your great clip. And we all agree, and there's no confusion about it. So you got to stop. You got to ring the bell. You got to subscribe to the Michael Knowles YouTube channel. And then we will see you next time.